Hello, Sophie here. So I recently got this comment suggesting that I try to make really quick videos that focus on one single topic at a time. And I thought, all right, that's a pretty good idea. So, noise modifier. Let's do this. So modifiers can be added in the modifiers properties, this blue wrench icon, and the noise modifier can be found in the deform category. So the very first things we see at the top are the name of the modifier, which we can modify. And there are also these three buttons. The first is edit mode. If you turn this off, you will not see the noise effect only when you go into edit mode. And this can be helpful for modifying the strokes because then you can see them exactly as they were when you drew them. The next is real time. If you turn this off, you will not see the noise modifier in any of the modes. If you have a lot of things in your scene, a lot of objects, a lot of animations, then having this hidden while you're working on your project can make the blend file just run more smoothly. And the last is render, and clicking it off will make the noise modifier not be applied to your final animation once you've rendered it. So this could be useful for doing test renders, where you'd like to focus on other parts of the animation but not the noise, and then you can add it back in when you're ready to do your final animation. Next up, exactly what about our drawings can we noise? The first is position. This affects the placement of the strokes, and so this just moves the strokes at random. Strength and thickness are just what they sound like. They randomize the thickness and the strength of the different strokes. And what about UV? If I put it all the way up to 1, I don't even notice any difference. So according to the Blender manual, this affects the point UV rotation. This would only make a difference if you use textured brushes. So to explain this, I'll use the grass brush from this textured brush pack, which I'll link below. How textured brushes work is that they have an image or a stamp that gets drawn with every vertex. You can see the image if I just press and release very quickly. And then if I go into edit mode and select everything, you can see that for each vertex, this stamp gets drawn. And so how these stamps merge together is what results in our textured brushes. So now if I add a noise modifier and I have it affect the UV, we can see that our grass stamps are rotating. But for the stroke that I have, they're all rotating in unison. So what's up with that? Well, the noise scale is what's up with that. So the higher you make the noise scale value, the more each vertex of a stroke will act independently of one another. So as I turn it up, ooh, you can see that now the UV rotation is not just affecting the stroke as a whole. If we go back to our previous example, and I use the position once again, you can see that upping the noise scale now makes the noise modifier affect the position of every vertex. And what's also really cool about all of these settings is that they can all be animated. Anytime you see this white dot next to a value, that means that you can keyframe it and you can animate it. We can start with the position at something truly ridiculous, like 5. So then at frame 1, we can press this dot to animate it. And then let's say at frame 75, we can bring it down to something a lot more realistic for line art, like 0.02, maybe 0.05. And then we can press it again to animate it. And then if we play our animation, not only do we have a noise modifier, but it also slowly comes into order. Tell me that's not super cool. So the next setting we have is randomize. So step defines how many frames will go by before the randomization changes. So by default, it's at 4. So the noise will stay the same for 4 frames. You can see the frame count down here before it changes again. We can make the randomization change faster by making the step count smaller or slower by making the step count larger. And seed, how I understand it, it's just a randomly generated pattern of how the noise will apply. There are some situations in which it could be useful, in which you'd want to use a different seed. I can't imagine that ever coming up for grease pencil, however, at least not in the ways that I've been using it. So for now, we can just forget about it. And then next, we have influence. This is where we can get some really cool effects, because rarely do you want to noise all parts of your drawing equally. The first option is layer. You would use this option if you wanted to select a layer for it to be applied to. For example, in this piece, I have it only affect the line art layer. And then the box next to this, and the box next to all of these, will do the inverse. So if I click it, we can now see that the noise modifier affects every layer except for the line art layer. Just below that, we have the pass index. This is just a number that you can give to however many layers you want. So we can do that in Object Data Properties, where we see our layers, and it can be found in Adjustments. So if I were to give multiple layers a pass index of 1, and then I go back into my modifiers and I select a pass index of 1, this will make the modifier affect all of the layers that have that pass index of 1. Just below that, we have material. This is helpful for when you have a lot of layers, as I do for this piece. And so I kept my layers quite separate so that I could go into edit mode, and so I could edit everything separately. But despite having all of these layers, I actually only have 2 materials. So I have a material for the line art, and I have a material for the fill colors. And so I can have this modifier affect the line art material. I find for the line art, what works best is to affect the position of the strokes, but I can also have this modifier, which affects the fill material. And for the fill, you can get really interesting results by having the noise modifier affect the strength and thickness of the strokes. And once again, you see the pass index. So that can be applied by going into the material properties, and it can be found in the options dropdown. So in a previous video, I kind of laughed about the chaos that happens when you just apply a noise modifier and the default position is set to 0.5. But I got a really interesting comment by someone who said that they liked the less clean look around the edges, and that they would be curious if there was a way to achieve this effect, but also keep, you know, the face not quite so chaotic. Well, for that, we can use the last option, vertex groups. So to use this, we first need to create a vertex group. So let's go back into Object Data Properties, and under Onion Skinning, we have vertex groups. So we can press the plus icon to make a new group. Then we can go into edit mode, and making sure that all of our layers are unlocked, you can do that by clicking unlock all. And we also want to make sure that up here, we are in vertex select mode so that we will select only the vertices and not the strokes as a whole. Then what we can do up here, if we're using the lasso select tool, we can just lasso select roughly her face. And then back to our vertex group, we can select assign. And then if we go back into object mode, into our modifiers, and in influence, select our group. And then we can use the inverse filter. And the result is a chaotic, really interesting looking drawing, but the face is still making sense, which if any part of it is gonna make sense, you'd want it to be the face. So last but not least, custom curve. What the heck is up with the custom curve? I had no idea up until this morning when I was planning out this video. So what I've discovered is that the y-axis, the up and down, represents the amount of noise, the degree of the noise, and the x-axis represents how the stroke was drawn. So I'll explain this by drawing a stroke now. I'll just go into edit mode, select all, and subdivide it so that we're sure we have enough vertices. So if at the start of the graph, I put the y-axis all the way to the top, and I have it go all the way to the bottom at the end of the graph. Here is what we get. You can see that all the noise now happens at the start of the stroke, the part of the stroke that I drew first. If we do the opposite, now the noise is strongest on the part of the stroke that I drew last. So by default, when we add a new noise modifier, the curve looks like this. This means that the middle of the stroke will have the most noise, and that both the start and end of the stroke will have virtually no noise. So when I played around with the custom curves in a big illustration where there's just a lot of strokes, the different effects that you can get aren't really noticeable on this large scale. And so if we want to take advantage of this, we'd need to be very minimal with our strokes and also intentional about how we draw them. Here are three examples I came up with of how this could be used in interesting ways. So I have this character, cute little girl, and maybe I want to give her some really crazy, really messy hair. The strands at the start, where the hair is leaving the pigtails, doesn't move, but the ends do. It definitely makes more sense than the strokes just moving at random and not staying to within the elastic. I also thought this could make a really cool, easy fire animation. The strokes, or the flames, move more the further away you get from the base of the fire. And again, without the custom curves, you just don't quite get that unified effect. And really, this can just be used for anything you can think of where you want one end of the strokes to move, but the other end to stay put. And once again, compare this to having no custom curve. And as a final bonus, while we're on the topic, did you know that you could also go into edit mode, select the strokes, and then in stroke, you can select switch direction. This will reverse how the strokes were drawn, or at least how Blender thinks the strokes were drawn, and will reverse the effect. All right. I just wanted to give a little shout out to Natalia at Illustradora3D on Instagram, who made this truly incredible botanical illustration using my grease pencil brushes. I think the subtle turnaround effect she added just adds another touch of magic to this already gorgeous illustration. I'm also pretty obsessed with her latest Blender botanical art, so definitely check out her account. And yeah, a massive thank you to Natalia and everyone else who's been using my brushes and tagging me in the results. It makes me so happy to see, and I'm so grateful for all of you. So I will link her Instagram as well as any other social media links in the video description. So I hope this was helpful. If you have used the noise modifier in an interesting way, I would love to hear about it. Definitely please share with me. I would love to see if you make anything inspired by any of my videos. You can tag me on Instagram and Twitter. I am at Sophie Jantak everywhere. Thank you so much for being here. I will see you very soon. Bye. I was originally gonna call this series Grease Pencil Tricks in 5 minutes or less, and then my script laughed in my face. I swear, I really tried to keep this one short, and then there was so much to talk about.